Hello, it's Michael from Red Chair Diaries, coming to you from my library in Nova Scotia, Canada, and it is Thursday, November 8th, I guess, 2 days after that American election, 2018. I did a video 2 years ago, I guess it was November 9th, I think it was the day after the presidential election, and it's still on my site. I think it was called Darkness Elegy for America, something like that. I mean, I found the results so depressing because of, you know, Donald Trump being so corrupt and a moron. And, you know, Clinton actually having, of course, won the vote. So, you know, there's at least two, if not three, elections in the last decade and a half, 18 years that have been basically stolen by the Republicans. So, don't have a lot of good to say for them. Anyway, with this election in the House of Representatives, I was going to say House of Commons because that's what we have in Canada. So the House of Representatives has swung back, and they have a lot of various powers that I don't understand all the divisions, but they have a lot of powers. Unfortunately, they don't have the power about the judges, you know, the Supreme Court and all of that sort of stuff. But, you know, they at least have powers to investigate. But there's an awful lot of damage can be done in 2 months' time. I mean, they've got over 2 months before these people take their oaths and whatever you have to do for the protocol. I think it's something like the third week in January, I think, before they actually assume their roles as the leaders of the House of Representatives. So that's bad. And the Orange Anus is already working overtime. Finally sent the Munchkin packing yesterday. And now has put in as the acting attorney general another sycophant who's been trying to get a job like that and is on record as saying he was going on CNN to get noticed by the White House. So this is, you know, typical Donald Trump flatter. And if you don't do it, he does it himself. So he gets all of his... what are the hits up here? Dopamine or some dopamine, is it? Whatever you get, like when you're a runner's high. And so he gets those every time he talks about how wonderful he is. So there's still a lot of damage can be done. I'm anxious to see what the Mueller probe brings about and whether it's stymied and canceled and smothered in its crib. I don't know. But man, those of you who are American citizens, sheesh, you have an awful lot to deal with. And if you're Trumpsters, you're certainly watching the wrong video channel. I can tell you that just by looking at what I record over the years. No nation is without its problems. Canada, our prime minister, who I like, and I liked his father before him, Pierre Trudeau, was the prime minister for most of the 70s and into the 80s, with a six-month hiatus when the opposition party, the Conservatives, defeated a budget. And then there was an election 6 months later and all of that sort of stuff. And Pierre Trudeau is back. But his son, Justin, is the prime minister now, leads the Liberal Party, which is like the Democratic Party in many ways. In Canada, the New Democratic Party is the more socialist party, and I like a lot of what they're in favor of, but I also like a lot of what the Liberals are in favor of. And even the Conservatives aren't a disaster, but they are more, they're closer to sort of a Republican mindset than I like. But Justin Trudeau is the leader of the Liberals, and yesterday he apologized for an incident in Canada's history where Canada's prime minister at the time in during World War II, or was it just prior to it? I'm not clear on my date, but they wouldn't let a ship called the Saint Louis discharge Jewish refugees on the Canadian soil at this point. And then some of them were, did end up dying back in Europe, I believe. Though several, I believe, were taken by England and Ireland, and that I, like I said, I haven't made a study of it. I'm just reading, newspaper accounts. So that certainly is a blight on our record. And once again, you have to look at it historically, as it wasn't considered as a terrible thing, and of course now it is, recognized for what it is. Which was, for many unfortunates, a prelude to Holocaust. But we have that in our history. We have dealings with the indigenous peoples that were also genocidal in intent and in execution in many ways, no pun intended. As you certainly have in the States with the Indian Wars and so on. So we have that. Japanese were, of course, suspect on the west coast of Canada during the Second World War. So I don't think we had internment camps. I really should know, but I don't at this point. But we've had our bad issues too. And I would never say otherwise, but I think for the most part, our politics are not as corrupt, or maybe I should say corrupted by one faction. In this case, people like Trump, Mitch McConnell, Paul Ryan, the whole spineless group. Terrible what it's done to democracy in the States and by extension democracy around the world. In Canada, we haven't had that sort of acidic and caustic insidious poison going through our political system. We have our own spots of mildew and mold throughout politics, of course, as well. And we of course we have corrupt people in government, but it's not a wholesale party of them. The our government is basically the British government, the parliamentary system. We have the same names for the branches of government. The House of Commons is the name for where the elected members that represent various geographical areas in the country and are members of a party, meet to make laws. We also have a Senate, which is probably more akin to the House of Lords in England. But our Senate is not elected, and I don't think the House of Lords is either, unless they changed that. I know a lot of excess fat was purged from that, I think, during the Tony Blair government. But our Senate is, the theory of our Senate is that it is therefore, I believe the expression is, sober reflection or sober review and reflection, considering there are many alcoholics there. The word sober probably didn't belong, but they are appointed by the prime minister. He gets his recommendations from his party and whatever, but it was usually, I think, considered a place where you put people who had done party work, and then they had a they had a good job, and they didn't have to work out in a field or drive a tractor, and then they got a gold-plated pension. I would our Senate, they have to retire at 75, I think that's one of the faults in the American system is that people are there way too long. I mean, that Grassley couldn't find his ass if he had a GPS. And, to be in charge of the Judicial Committee just because he's been there a long time, it's just disgusting. The white party, the white male party, the Republicans, terrible. Our government, on the whole, I'll say our members of parliament, are more reflective with different ethnicities, of which I'm glad to see. And we've had leaders of the New Democratic Party, of the female gender. I think two successive leaders were women a few years back. We've had Prime Minister, that was a woman, it was no big deal, and so on, And the Prime Minister is the leader of the party that has the most, that has won the most seats in a federal election. We also have a Governor General, which is a ceremonial role that is, it's called a viceregal role because they represent, in this case, these days, Queen Elizabeth II. And it's the Governor General that gives royal assent, signs the bills. It's not like the Prime Minister, the President of the States having to sign bills and veto and all of that shit. No. If they're presented with the bill, once it goes through Parliament and the Senate, they sign it. They don't have to argue about it. And each province we have two or three territories still called territories and not provinces. And they have a lieutenant governor who does the same function on the provincial level of giving royal assent because we are still in the monarchy system. Queen Elizabeth is technically considered the Queen of Canada. I'm not crazy about the monarchy. I would just as well be a republic with and keep these same sort of functions and decorum, but it doesn't really piss me off one way or the other. I can deal with the royal family. Thank you very much. Anyway, those are things that I just wanted to talk. I'm not as depressed as I was 2 years ago, I'll tell you. Oh my God, I thought it was bad. Anyway, it's Michael from Red Chair Diaries, coming to you from my library, my lower level library in Nova Scotia, Canada. It's kind of cloudy. I can see blue skies, so it's alternately cloudy and sunny. About 15 degrees outside my window, I think, which is about 30, like probably about 60 degrees Fahrenheit. I think so, yeah. Anyway, that's it for now, and I hope you enjoy your day and that you enjoyed my blathering. Okay, see you around.